Without question, many people struggle to cope with such painful loss. For those dealing with trauma here in Pittsburgh, there's a place to turn for emotional help and for healing. Channel 4 Action News anchor Sally Wiggin takes us there.
10-year-old Noah Nukowski and his 13-year-old sister Emily lost their father 5 years ago. Sunday, at the Caring Place ceremony of remembrance, the kids did just that, remembered.
When I lit that candle, I feel like my dad was over me, smelling at me, saying, "Good job, you did something on your own."
Noah and his sister are still coming to the Highmark Caring Place with their mother. So far, she has not seen that the Newtown tragedy has been an emotional trigger for them.
Anytime we see something on the news that something has happened to somebody else, they have extra sympathy, it seems. You know, oh, that's so awful. I can't imagine what their families are feeling.
And Emily remembers those first days after her father's death.
When it first happened, like, you don't even know what to feel, but it does get better. Like, it's never going to go away. There's still, like, always going to be this space in your heart that's empty, but it does get better.
And while Caring Place Director Therese Vorshek says they won't bring up the Newtown tragedy to the kids.
If the children bring it up and they want to talk about it, what we'll do is we provide the space for them to talk about it, and we listen.
And these are the names of the 3,000 children who've been through the Caring Place so far. Here is Emily's, and here is Noah's. At the end of their sessions, they're told that the names are placed here in honor of the courage it took for them to come to deal with grief and other difficult emotions. It's called, appropriately, the Tree of Growth, their growth. Sally Wiggin, Channel 4 Action News.